guys, Data Baby, you're up.
Hello everyone, my name is Sri and this is Anand with me, and we are team DataBeacon, and we are here to pitch our idea for a restaurant chatbot. So in this competitive age, all we need is decision making. Do I need to have American cuisine or do I need to have Italian cuisine for tonight? Or if I'm someone who is moving new to the area, I want to know which restaurant is good nearby. It's all about decision making, and when it comes to food and safety, it's really important that we have as much as accurate information as we can. Our restaurant chatbot's customer base is anyone who loves food and anyone who wants to try different kinds of food nearby. And this is beneficial for the restaurant owners as well. They can come up with, they can self-identify themselves in the market, and they can get to know what they are in the market. So a solution is to come up with a chatbot. Chatbot are the most growing technology right now, and there's a lot of open source opportunities for them. There's Facebook Messenger bot, there's a lot of independent chatbot as well. But for this specific use case, to make restaurant-based decisions for us, we are here to come up with an idea that uses open source data and apply machine learning on top of that and make some decisions which are relatable to our questions. So it's all about natural language processing and natural language text understanding. Our data source is Yelp API, so Yelp provides a good amount of restaurant based data that we are going to leverage it. It's all in JSON format, and we can use open source technologies such as natural language toolkit. This is Stanford NLP parser as well, and this we have a lot of open source databases that we can leverage. So it's all about leveraging the open source environment. The uniqueness about our application is that it uses open source, and we use machine learning to build our model. So when there is more data sources, we can provide more accurate response to the queries that we have. And the technologies that we use are also open source. We are using the natural language toolkit that the Python has it in built-in. We are also using the Stanford parser, which is another open source technology that Stanford provides. And all our data and data sources are well loaded into MongoDB collection. And what we need is to purchase additional disk space that we can store more data. Our business model as of now is an open source project. It is hosted in GitHub, but we are very much welcoming on any other users who want to contribute to that project. The competitors for now is that there are a lot of chatbots that is targeting specific to restaurants. For example, Domino's has a specific chatbot that answers or that orders food for them, but there is no chatbot that answers these kind of restaurant-based information. Some example that we have come up with is in this case I have a question called which Burger King has delivery options. It is completely natural language, and we process this question and compare it with the data that we have, and it identifies which restaurant it has, and it returns a list of Burger King places nearby that has delivery options. Another question is, I'm asking about this particular restaurant called City Travel, and it identifies it as an organization, and it looks up the reviews posted in Yelp.com, and comes up with a response based on that. Another example is what is the price range of Papa John's pizza, and it again looks up the Yelp dataset. It comes up with the price range factor, which is 2 in all the cases. So these are some of the examples that we've been working on, but we are constantly trying to improve the model by adding additional data or fine-tuning our machine learning model. And we are looking for UI developers who can come up with a good front-end platform for that, so that it is pretty much useful to the user and it is ease of use for the user. We have a couple of ideas, like we are planning to do a Facebook Messenger bot, and we have also had some great ideas from the audience here. Some of them pitched for an Alexa application, which is also a good source of front-end.
So, question for you. Since you're using Yelp data, what exactly is the value add of your chatbot in terms of what I can already do with Yelp?
So, what we're trying to do is we are trying to make decision-based queries. So, if you go to Yelp website, it just lists out a bunch of restaurants of your choice based on your options that you give. But what our chatbot, what we are trying to do is, it's to make decisions for you. Like if you are interested in American cuisine, we can list out the top American cuisines based on the reviews. We can look into individual reviews and see how it is when compared to the other restaurants, and we can return the top nearby restaurants for you. So it's all about decision making.
So in terms of the machine learning itself, is it mostly natural language processing? So the user, I'm guessing, can provide a specific question. What is the level of sanitation of, I don't know, making up this question, Mexican food restaurants in this area? So is your model then going to look at all the Yelp reviews for Mexican restaurants in this area and then provide an answer based on that?
Yeah, so there's two approaches that we are following. One is for straightforward questions. For example, you want to know the rating of this particular restaurant. If this data available, so for a particular Mexican restaurant, there is already a data available in Yelp.com, so it just returns the value. But if you want to know something more than that, you want to know how the sanitation is, or how hygienic the food is, or how are the customers responding to the food over there, you can look into individual reviews. Like the model looks into the individual reviews. It applies a kind of an algorithm that that makes the review into a single text. So it's either sentiment analysis or it's either classification algorithm. So it is something beyond just looking into a data and giving it as a response.
What would be your process to build in some geospatial or spatial component for people to connect with the most, with whatever their choice is for food finding, and how often would the data be updated, and how would you do that?
So Yelp provides an academic data set that is just a partial data of what they have. It's just 2 million records, and it has
thanks. Let's give everyone a big hand. So we're going to take a break while the judges deliberate. I would ask everybody, we've got a hashtag Citycamp NC. If you're on Twitter, just take a minute, tweet a little bit about the event. Judges will be back shortly, and we'll go to the grand prize. Thank you.